EC. So proof is any triangle ABC and triangle ADE. This is triangle ABC and this is triangle ADE. Angle B is equal to angle D. This angle B is equal to this angle D because these two lines are parallel lines and AB is transversal. And you know when a transversal intersects two parallel lines, the corresponding angles are equal. Similarly, angle C equal to angle E. Now, by AA rule of similarity, triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADE. The one thing you should remember, the angle D equal to angle B. Therefore, the place of D and D are same when you write the name of triangle. Similarly, angle C equal to angle E, then position of C and E are same while writing the name of triangle. Now you know, if two triangles are similar, then the ratio of their sides are also equal. It means side AB of first triangle upon side AD of second triangle is equal to side BC of first triangle upon side DE of second triangle is equal to AC of first triangle and AE of second triangle. Now, we can left this ratio because we have to prove ratio of AB and AC equal. Therefore, we take these two ratios because here is AB and here is AC. Now, AB upon AD equal to AC upon AE. From the figure, you can see clearly, we can write AB as AD plus DB. AD plus DB and AD remains as it is. Similarly, in place of AC, you can write AE plus EC. AE plus EC and AE remains as it is. And now you can write this AD in the upon of AD and DB separately. So AD upon AD and DB upon AD. Similarly, AE upon AE plus EC upon AE. This becomes 1 and this also becomes 1. This 1 and 1 cancel. Now you get DB upon AD is equal to EC upon AE. Students, you know if 2 upon 4 equal to 8 upon 16, then you can write 4 upon 2 equal to 16 upon 8. It means if two ratios are equal, their reciprocal are also equal. So taking reciprocals, AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. This is the required proof of the theorem. Thank you.